Hi guys! So today, I have a totally crazy, insane Star Wars theory for the Mandalorian. Is Moff Gideon actually working for Thrawn? I know, you're probably thinking, what? But let me explain. So Thrawn is still supposedly missing in action. We know for sure because Ahsoka is still looking for him, and most likely Ezra too. What if he's actually hiding out in the shadows, secretly putting things into action? Thrawn is a genius, a master tactician. If anyone could be playing the cards here, it would be Thrawn. Also, Gideon is a Moff. He would more than likely know or at least have heard of Thrawn. Also, if you all will remember those really amazing Star Wars Legends novels by Timothy Zahn, Thrawn took over the Empire after Vader and Palpatine's demise. What if this is happening again, but in a newer, canon way? On The Mandalorian, do you remember that female Imperial in green that seems to be Moff Gideon's right-hand man, or, well, woman? What if this is Commodore Karen Farrow from the Thrawn Origin trilogy? I know, there's like no evidence of this, but she does fit Farrow's description, and it would make sense that she's working for Gideon, because Thrawn is the one who recruited her. So, she's worked in the Empire a long time and she served under Thrawn. She really does respect him and she understands how good of a leader he was. She might have lost faith in the Empire, but if she saw that Thrawn was coming back to take it over, she probably knew that he would be able to take control of it. Do I have anything more to add to this theory? Yes. So we know Moff Gideon wants Baby Yoda, or Grogu, but we don't know why yet. What if Thrawn is actually really after him? Let me explain. So in the Thrawn books, we learn about the Skywalkers, Force-sensitive Chiss, which is what Thrawn's people are called. Now, they usually only have their powers for a handful of their younger years, but in the third Thrawn book, Thrawn Treason, it was made clear that the Chiss wanted to learn more about how the Force worked, or second or third sight as they called it. Eli Vanto, a fellow Imperial friend of Thrawn's, left the Empire and went on to study about it. Well, just maybe Thrawn is trying to get Grogu so he can learn more about the Force and ways to help his people. Thrawn has also said in Rebels how he finds the Force quite fascinating. I don't think it would be too far of a stretch for him wanting to experiment and learn more about Grogu. Now, I know, a lot of this doesn't add up. If you know Thrawn like I do, he actually is a good leader and he appoints capable people to do the right job. So why would he hire Moff Gideon, of all people, to find and locate Grogu? Well, maybe because he's short on hand, or he has other plans for him. Thrawn knows what his enemies and allies want, and he lets them play to keep going. Moff Gideon seems to be power-hungry and seems like he has his own goals. Maybe he does, and he plans to exclude Thrawn from them. That would explain things like the whole clone thing from all that episodes we were seeing, and a lot about like that. Moff Gideon might be acting like he's working for Thrawn, but he actually has some of his own plans in mind. It's also possible that Thrawn helped Gideon get the Darksaber. He knew quite a lot about Sabine Wren, and he had to have spent quite a lot of time with Ezra. These two characters have a close connection with Bo-Katan, lightsabers, and the Darksabers. I don't think it would be too far out for Thrawn to hint to Gideon on how to get the Darksaber. If this crazy idea did turn out to be true, can we just brainstorm a little on what we might be getting? Maybe we'll see more Nogri like Rook. I would love to see Boba Fett duel one. After that last episode, I want to see a lot more of him in action. So that was my complete theory on Thrawn actually being behind all of this. It would be crazy, entertaining, and yes, a little near to impossible, but you never know what could happen. So far, The Mandalorian Season 2 has been some of the best Star Wars content we've ever seen, in my opinion, of course. I can't wait for what's more to come, and I hope that we get to see Thrawn sometime soon. An awesome character like him deserves to return to the spotlight.